I'm here for the third and final round of this Time Spiral draft. I'm on the play with a four lander, which I don't love, but I do love my turn one suspend Ivory Giant. And my opponent's got turn one suspend also. Man, I feel like not only do I always draw the Errant Doomsayers, but I always draw both. They're just pretty bad. I put them in my deck because I thought they'd maybe sometimes be okay, and they're Rebels. But I've never searched for one, and I've always drawn them, and they're just really not that good. But I can tap down some Goblin tokens this game, and they are good for casting Gaze of Justice at least. Oh, it's toughness two or less. The whole time I've been thinking it was power two or less. I don't think that would have made a difference in any of the situations that actually came up, but the fact that I can tap down this Halberdiers really changes the value of the card. I could have sworn it was power two or less. Echo or no echo? Echo. So I can either attack for two. I guess I'll attack for two and play my morph. And my opponent has missed a land drop, so if I get to put the Ivory Giant into play when he still hasn't done much, I'm going to have a lot of control over this game. Alright, that's fine. No big deal there. Now, I could Gaze of Justice the Goblin, but then the Undying Rage is going to come back anyway, so it doesn't seem like that effective of a play. Zealot's going to be pretty good in this board state. And, as I recently learned, I get to tap down this 4-1 creature with my Doomsayer. Maybe I spoke too soon. Maybe it is a good card. So I get hit for three, Ivory Giant comes in, I get to use the Zealot to ping the Halberdiers. I could see leaving the Giant on defense if I want, although usually when your opponent has missed land drops, it's a good philosophy to be a little more aggressive, because if you just let the game drag on, they'll eventually draw out of their mana screw and then have a stacked hand. The fact that my opponent did nothing makes me think he's going to burn the Zealot or something like that. Lightning Axe the Giant. Okay. Sure. And then he's just going to flashback Conflagrate on my whole team. Maybe I should... I definitely can't I do anything besides attack with the Zealot. attack with two of these guys. And that's what I got. So here's a spot where Conflagrate's going to be good. I mean, just killing a bunch of 1-1s and 2-2s. I wonder how much my opponent will actually be willing to discard, though. Discards his whole hand, he kills my whole board. What? That does not make much sense to me. Conflagrate has a special flashback card, cost, discarding cards from your hand. So it's actually cheaper in terms of mana to flashback than it is to cast. Now that was... I would have preferred to draw some spells, but now that I can... turn this face up, start mowing down goblins. I like where I'm at. Ooh, okay, so my opponent's not mono-red, and also has Teferi. It's going to kill my whole squad, so in response, I turn this up, I kill the goblin, and now it's just a 3-3 against nothing, and I got to hope to top deck. Think twice in the graveyard, actually, for my opponent, so if he draws an island, he can get back in it. I need to draw my Icacian Crier, maybe. Or just Temporal Isolation. That's probably the best draw. Plains is not. I think I'm going to need Temporal Isolation this turn. That might not even be enough at this point. Good game. Well, my opponent had a bunch of one toughness guys, so I can bring in all this crazy stuff if I want. What do I have to take out? The blink. The crier. Crook claw. And I'll bring these out for my sliver package. Sure. I feel like Griffin Guide is going to be excellent against this guy. If I just get a quick draw with Griffin Guide, I'll be happy. Pretty good hand. How many blue cards do I even have left in my deck? Is it just the fledgling Mawkor. Maybe it's better to be mono white, but the Mawkor is good. So double lightning axe, conflagrate, probably some blue flyers, the undying rage, some goblins. I think I can beat this deck. Yeah. Just drew a few too many lands in game one, but I'm confident that I can win the next two. Conflagrate actually is pretty brutal against my deck. Almost everything I have is one toughness. One pretty insane card in this format for red is Sulfur Blast. It's only an uncommon, and it can deal 3 damage to each creature and each player for 4 mana. So against a deck like mine, it just wipes everything. Pentarch Ward, naming red, would have been good in game one when my opponent didn't have any blue mana. I wonder if he's got bounce spells, anything to deal with the Pentarch Ward if I do name red. It's also a pretty sweet combo, Outrider Encore, if I give a different creature protection from red, then I can just redirect all the damage from red sources to the protection of red creature. We'll see how it plays out. Still, this is the 7th game of the draft and I haven't yet to search for a rebel. I guess there's just too many ways to kill one toughness guys. That card's good against my deck, too. Maybe this is not a good matchup for me. We'll see. Ouch. Yeah, I think I need Griffin Guide. I think that's gonna be my best card. No whammies, no whammies. I can start just picking off goblins with the Zealot, which is good. Opponent still has 6 cards in hand, though. I boarded in my one toughness guys that are good against one toughness guys, but my opponent has all this cheap burn that's already good against one toughness guys, so who can outping the other? My opponent's playing pretty slowly, which doesn't bother me, but annoying for the purposes of the video, I apologize. Yeah, on my turn, I guess I'm going to... Well, it totally depends what my opponent does, but assuming he just taps out for a creature or something, probably going to Pentarch Ward the Zealot. Give it protection from red. Well, that looks like a Teferi if I've ever seen one. Which is annoying because I don't really want to cast the Pentarch Ward into open mana, but if my opponent does cast Teferi, he's going to have open mana for the whole rest of the game. Okay, so I will suit him up. Protection from red. Man, I'm drawing too many lands. Looks like my opponent has some cool storm stuff going on. Empty the Warrens. Okay. My opponent could have just played that island and hard cast the Lightning Axe. There we go. One damage. Okay, so do I Griffin Guide the Zealot and have a protection from red attacker? Or do I Griffin Guide the Quilled Sliver and have 4 power worth of attackers? Maybe you have the option to block if I need to. I guess that's better. Maybe it was not wise to Pentarch Ward the Zealot because it can't block. I could use this on defense, but for starters, I think I want to just get in with both and see what I draw. If I draw a blank here, maybe I have to leave the sliver on defense. Interesting. Yeah, let me leave the sliver on defense now. Play this as a morph for some very minor, unimportant deception. Sure, my opponent has a good idea of what it is. Sure. Okay, so I think I just block and ping Teferi. And then I can ping the spike tail. And I'm in pretty good shape. Still can't very easily deal with the coal stoker, but I can try to race it. Okay, I can still kill the spike tail before combat damage, because this triggers immediately after blockers are declared. But I should have thought about that before. Yeah, I mean, it's definitely a good block by my opponent, because this creature is going to die anyway. So let's see. I go down to 5, he goes down to 7, I go down to 2, he goes down to 2, but I can leave a blocker. I guess I can just trade my Maw Core off too. Ooh, that's kind of a nice draw. It's annoying that I have to trigger this every time, even if I just want to deal my regular combat damage. Alright, play the knight. If my opponent draws another land, I'm going to be in really good shape here. Sure. Another creature that I can just mow down with my pingers. Gonna block. I was lucky this game. My opponent had me on the ropes, but then got a little bit flooded himself. He could still draw like some kind of fireball card and just kill me. Guess he's 2 lands away from Conflagrate being lethal. So if he was to draw Conflagrate and hit me for 4, then I would kill him on the backswing, so he'd have to burn my creatures. But he could burn my 2/2 flyers. Alright, so how do I want to manage this? I probably want to leave these two on defense. Alright, please don't draw anything too crazy. I'm going to double block if he attacks and just ping him, I suppose. All right. So we're one game away from being the Time Spiral champion of the world. Deavenant Healer is not that bad against all the one mana burn and whatnot. I could play the Icacian Crier. I don't like the Icacian Crier. Do I have anything in my deck that's bad. No, I think I like everything that's in there. So I'm going to submit this. One last go at it. Pretty nice hand. Need my opponent to not Teferi my Ivory Giant. It is unlucky that I've played against Teferi twice, but lucky that it has never stopped any of my suspend cards. Overall, I think I've been running very good in this draft. My opponent missed a land drop. Knight of the Holy Nimbus is remarkably hard to kill when you only have one mountain in play. If you have, like, three, it's still hard to kill, but... I wonder what's up with my opponent keeping that hand, I guess just a one-lander with Think Twice or something. So, I probably want to just suspend, attack for two. So again, another case where I have to be careful to cast this before I cast this. I wonder, they made an interesting card here. Like, they built an interesting dynamic into the draft format by giving white a bunch of really good enchantments and having one of its best creatures destroy an enchantment when it comes into play. It's a weird little dance you have going there. Also, the other ability is very bizarre. It's like if you can make your secondary color creatures not get tapped to an Ivory Giant by making them white. Or you can cast a Pentarch Warden, name white, and then turn all their stuff white. It's weird. So... if I could change anything about this deck, I think the deck was really good. Everything was kind of well in place, but the only difference was that, or the only thing that I didn't love was that all my guys, or too many of my guys were one power. I didn't really have enough heavy hitters like the Knight. But if you just gave me like some more two power attackers, a Knight, maybe a Sultari Priest, anything like that, deck would have been really good. But it was good as it is. And looks like my opponent has decided to concede here, so I do win the draft. Wish we'd gotten one more good game here, but you got to see some cool stuff. My favorite game was the Ivory Giant Momentary Blink one right at the beginning. Anyway, I have a lot of fun with this format. If you ever have a chance to play it, I definitely recommend it. But until then, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Thanks a lot for watching.